सेल कल्चर ऑफ सिंगल सेल इलेक्टेड सिंगल सेल ऑन द न्यूट्रिएंट मीडियम इज कॉल्ड सेल कल्चर. सेल कल्चर मेथड्स दे आर फॉलोइंग स्टेप्स. फर्स्ट स्टेप इज isolation of single cell from plant organs. Isolation of single cell from plant organs by two methods. One is mechanical method, second one is enzymatic method. Which cell is used for culture? That cell collected from the plant organs. From plant organs, they collected only single isolated cell, not cells. We collect only single cell. Which cell is used for culture? That cell is collected from the plant organs by two methods. One is mechanical method, second one is enzymatic method. Mechanical method means which plant part organ is selected from the plant. That organ containing mass of cells. From that mass of cells, we need only single cell. That organ is treated with or kept in homozygine machine. It is the synthesized machine. This machine mainly helps in isolation of single cell from plant organs. So we used machines in this method, so we called mechanical method. And the second one is enzymatic method means plant organs are treated with chemicals. Already we know plant organ made by different types of cells or mass of cells. From that mass of cells, we need only single cell. The single cell is isolated from the plant organ by enzymatic method. During the enzymatic method, we add chemicals. The chemicals are mainly isolated. Chemicals are mainly helps in isolating of single cell from the plant organs. That chemicals are called memorozymes. It is the selection of single cell from plant organ. Sometimes we selected cells or cell from the cultured cell. See, it is the first step of cell culture. Then after isolation of single cell from plant organ or from the cultured cells, single cell transferred into nutrient medium. By the nutrient medium, two types of cultures here after inoculation of single cell. One is batch culture, second one is continuous culture. These are the two steps in the culture. It is the second step of the single cell culture. In batch culture, we take one beaker, it filled with nutrient, MS medium nutrient. Again, we add or we transfer selected single cell on the nutrient medium. After, we call inoculation. This process is called inoculation. Inoculation means selected isolated single cell transfer into the nutrient medium called inoculation. After inoculation in batch culture, mainly five stages are there, five phases. First phase is log phase. Log phase is also called start phase. If single cell transfer into the nutrient medium, the single cell utilized nutrients is called the starting phase or start phase, is also called log phase. Later, the single cell started utilizing of nutrients, it can participate in the cell divisions. The cell division stage is called log phase. Cell division phase is called log phase. After log phase, the cell division is completed. Cell divisions are completed. Mass of cells are formed by utilizing of nutrients. So mass of cells, number of cells are formed by the cell division. This phase is called growth phase. After completion of growth phase, all cells utilize nutrients from the beaker, from the nutrient medium. So they cannot participate in the cell division. Some cells, only few cells participated in the cell division. This stage is called declaration phase or slow cell division. Why they are participated in the slow cell division means nutrients are completed. Nutrients are completed in the beaker. There is no nutrients. If any nutrients are present, some nutrients are present, that nutrients are utilized by the some cells. That some cells are participated in only division. They participate in the slow cell division. Final phase after declaration is final phase is there. The final phase is also called the stationary phase. In this stationary phase, cell divisions are stopped. At final, in batch culture, we collected mass of cells or number of cells in one batch called batch culture. At initially in log phase, we inoculated only single cell. But at final phase, we collected mass of cells. Number of cells are cultured from the single cell in a batch culture. Now next method is continuous phase. Continuous phase is also called closed phase or closed phase. Closed phase means continuously we add nutrients to cell or cells. Continuously added nutrients to the cell. So this phase is called continuous phase. This phase is also called open phase. Open phase means already nutrients added. Again, nutrients are decreased or disappeared when we add nutrients. When we add nutrients to the culture is called closed open phase. Closed phase means when we add nutrients is called closed phase. When we again re-added the nutrients to the culture is called open phase. From these two culture, in batch culture, we add nutrient only once. But in continuous phase, we add nutrients continuously. The nutrients adding by two methods. One is closed phase method, open phase method. After completion of these culture, we collected mass of cells from the batch culture or from the continuous culture. The next phase is synchronization. Synchronization means all cells are in similar structure. all cells are in similar structure for simultaneous division. Simultaneous division means all cells are participated in at a time division, called synchronization of divisions. By the synchronization, all cells participated in simultaneous division. For the synchronization, we provide physical method at 4 degrees Celsius temperature. At chemical method, 5 amino purine chemical and colchicine. When we added these chemicals for the synchronization, the all cells are participated in the simultaneous division. Or for the synchronization, we provide 4 degrees Celsius temperature, all cells are participated in the simultaneous divisions. Then after synchronization, cell counting. For cell counting, we add chemical chromic acid. We add chemical for the cell or cells for cell counting, chromic acid. After adding of chromic acid, the cells are kept under the hemocytometer. We can easily identify the cells. We can easily count the cells under hemocytometer. Then after final stage is cell viability. The cell viability, for the cell viability, which cells are in alive condition? The cells are called viability cells. The viability cells are selected from the counting, selected from the culture batch only. Then for the cell viability, we add Evans blue color. After adding of Evans blue color, the cells are kept under phase contrast microscope. Phase contrast microscope. If we can easily identify which cells are absorbed Evans blue, that cells are in living conditions, that cells are having viability. Which cells are cannot absorb Evans blue, that cells are dead cells, are dead cells. So finally, after completion of cell viability, we can easily collect cells from the single cell culture. It is the procedure of cell culture.